Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I will be live in Orlando for Administrative Professional Conference on September 13th doing Microsoft 365 new and upcoming features. I hope to see you there. I'll be covering Excel, Word, PowerPoint, Outlook, Teams, OneNote, all new features that have just recently come out or are coming out soon. Cool feature, if you're a Microsoft Teams user and you're in Teams meetings, watch this video. Let's dive into it right now. I have Teams running. I'm already in a meeting. I called the meeting pop out feature test one up in the top middle. It is my meeting, but it doesn't matter whose meeting it is. In case you're wondering, how do you know it's my meeting? Because if I click here, I have end meeting. I'm the organizer. I clicked on this specifically to show you this. Everyone that's in the meeting on the desktop has this in the far right. People is where it'll stop, but you notice it doesn't say anything about pop out. No one is sharing now, and right now this meeting is just Carol Wilson and myself. I could have 20 people in here, cameras on, cameras off, it doesn't matter, but usually there are people that have their camera on, like myself. So Carol is going to now share her screen, and Carol is sitting on this laptop right here. So watch this. Carol clicks on share, and she hits screen. Now that Carol is sharing her screen, if you look up here at the top, you will see pop-out content. Cool feature. So the whole purpose of this is I still want to see everything that Carol is showing on her screen, but I want to see all the people in the meeting in a much larger view than I'm getting here, or depending on how many people you have in your meeting, they may go across the top. But here you go, pop out, watch this. It makes an entirely new window. It does open up the participant panel. You can close the participant panel by either clicking on people or hitting the X. I have two monitors. I'll be looking at all 20 people. I would drag this over to my second monitor. What if you don't have two monitors? And by the way, I would drag this over to my second monitor and look. Here is still the screen share from Carol. What if you don't have two monitors? Do you remember the Windows keyboard trick for this? I want this screen to be over on the far left of my one monitor. I'm going to hold down the Windows key. It is two places to the left of the space bar and tap the left arrow key, and now it is here. And then I want this screen to be on the right, Windows key, right arrow, and then I can sit here and decide how I want to view this. So anyway, there you go with that Windows trick if you only have one. It's a much better if you have two, put them on one monitor and the screen on another. Now, when Carol stops sharing, so here is a stop share from Carol. Close this out or hit dismiss, it doesn't matter. Maximize. I am back to just viewing everyone on one monitor. Really, really cool feature. I do want to cover this point. Carol shared in this example, and if there were 20 people in this meeting and someone else shared, I would have pop-out content. But when you share, so now this is me, this is Chris Menard. I'm going to go and share screen. So I am sharing my desktop. I can be sharing whatever I want to. I do not have pop out because I'm the person that's sharing. And here's a tip from me in case you didn't know this. When you're sharing this thing right here, you can actually move this to another window and maximize it. A lot of people don't know that tip. And just to prove it, double click, drag it over to my second monitor, and I can see all 20 people much larger than that little box that you get down there in the bottom right here. A lot of people don't know that feature. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope to see you in Orlando this year, and if not, catch me next year. Thank you for your time. Any comments or suggestions, please put them below. Ring the bell, subscribe, and have a wonderful day. Thank you.